while the crew of STS-116 sleeps. The International Space Station and the Space Shuttle Discovery get pummeled by powerful solar flares. In the morning, astronauts seem safe, but the station's systems are not.
Anytime that you have highly radioactive impacts, any type of an electronic system has the ability to be compromised.
A solar storm normally limits its mischief to destroying computers or tablets. This storm has taken out something much bigger.
The space station started acting a little funny. During this solar event, NASA realized that the space station's computers were having trouble keeping orientation.
Engineers quickly try to diagnose the problem. It appears that the storm has damaged the system that keeps the space station stable. NASA must devise a plan to get the station back on track, or risk burning through precious fuel trying to keep it properly placed.
If you only have so much propellant, you don't want to go ahead and waste it to boost the attitude, because maybe you've got another resupply mission coming up in 2 months, and guess what? They have a problem, and that extra gas you were counting on coming, it's not coming.
Now, astronauts must realign the space station using the Space Shuttle Discovery. It's a delicate procedure that requires extreme precision.
The station itself is actually really fragile. When you fire something, you could damage the station in the process.
The day after the solar bombardment, Commander Mark Polansky fires up Discovery's thrusters. Every burst will place them in a new spin. Any miscalculation could put the ISS on the wrong course. Too much thrust might damage the station.
You wind up having to very carefully have a series of, you do a pulse, get a little bit of a force, so it gets just a little bit of extra motion. And then you could do another one and another one. You just don't burn the jets and say go, and have all this force going at the system at once.
Slowly, the station repositions. The shuttle's maneuvering is right on the money. By the next day, NASA has the station's attitude control back online. Now the crew can enjoy the positive side of a solar storm. The Aurora Borealis.
The X-classes can really amp up those Northern Lights displays. Those are ones that we look forward to because they can cause these dazzling light displays. They can really supercharge the Auroras.
The Aurora is a constant reminder of the built-in shield that the Earth's magnetic field protects us with every day.